Good evening and welcome to Wednesday nights, We're on the Ball with me, Adam Grice. Tonight we will feature Jeff and Matt's wise words as usual. Guys, what are tonight's topics?
We've got all the talk from the transfer deadline day deals, including Andy Carroll's £35 million switch to Liverpool and Fernando Torres leaving Anfield to join Chelsea for £50 million.
Also, Matt and I have been down to the Gow Farm for pre-match build-up of Huddersfield's League One encounter against Carlisle. We've been speaking to fans and have an exclusive interview with injured striker Jordan Rhodes.
If you want to have your say on tonight's show, text us on 81188. You can also get in touch with us via our Facebook page at We're On The Ball Official, or you can tweet us at We're On The Ball Live. But first, here's Jules Leanne with the sports news.
Thanks, Adam. England's cricketers have lost their latest match in Australia, despite making the highest ever one-day international total against the hosts. They made 333 for 6 in the 50 overs, only to see their opponents reach their victory target with 4 balls to spare. England captain Andrew Strauss tells Sky Sports News it's hard to hide his feelings.
Yeah, just bitter, I think, if I'm honest. 333 is an outstanding score on any ground. It was a good wicket. We let them get off to far too fast a start, and then they're able to keep up with the rate.
Tom Wood will make his England debut on Friday night's Rugby Union Six Nations opener with Wales. The Northampton flanker will start in a team that will be captained by Mike Tindall, who's the skipper in place of the injured Lewis Moody. One of swimming's all-time legends, Ian Thorpe, says a visit to London's Olympic Park is behind his decision to come out of retirement. The Australian five-time Olympic champion is making a comeback in time for 2012. He's been training at 8 different pools in a bid to keep the new secret, but he's pleased it's now public knowledge.
I think, the fundamental one now is just being able to get on with it. Everyone knows what I'm doing now, and I really need to be able to focus in on that.
It looks like Stephen Fletcher could have played his final match for Scotland. The Wolves striker has apparently refused to call up by text message for next week's match against Northern Ireland. He's won 8 caps, but was also left out of recent lineups. Arsenal manager Arsene Wenger has accused Chelsea of hypocrisy over the big money January transfer deals. Chelsea had promised to support new measures encouraging clubs to watch the finances and break even each year. But on Monday, they announced losses of nearly £69 million, hours before spending another £70 million on 2 new players. Tottenham are without Luka Modric for tonight's Premier League trip to Blackburn. He's had his appendix removed and will be out for 2 weeks, which means he could miss the first leg of the Champions League tie with AC Milan. Manager Harry Redknapp has been impressed with this evening's opponents in recent times.
Tough game, in good form. He's done a good job there. Steve Keane, he's got him playing well, and difficult when he took over from Sam, and not an easy act to follow, but he's done great, and they're playing well.
Newcastle play the first game since the departure of Andy Carroll when they go to Fulham in the Premier League tonight. He went to Liverpool on transfer deadline day for £35 million. Magpies boss Alan Pardew says everyone involved with the team has to move on quickly. Luis Suarez is on course to make his Liverpool debut tonight. The £23 million capture from Ajax is in the squad for the Premier League clash with Stoke. Manager Kenny Dalglish is convinced he'll be a great signing.
He's a top class player and somebody that they have put their hand in their pocket to bring in. He's been on the radar for a while.
In the rest of tonight's action, title chasers Manchester City are at Birmingham, while Blackpool host West Ham and Bolton face Wolves. In League One, Huddersfield Town take on Carlisle. We'll have more on that, including an interview with Jordan Rhodes later on in our show. That's the sport news. I'll be back in half an hour with another update. Back to Adam.
Thanks, Jules. We've already had some messages in via Facebook. Mike in Homefirth says, I see that all the press and everyone keeps talking about Andy Carroll, and I'm not knocking him. I think he will be a great player for us, but I think it's going to be Suarez that will be taking the headlines in the future. His movement, skill and eye for goal is going to light up the Premier League. Max in Kirkburton is a Chelsea fan, and he's delighted they have signed Torres, despite having to pay £50 million for him. This signing will only create additional competition for Drogba and Anelka, Chelsea till I die, he says. On the text, with Helen in Harrogate, she says, I am thrilled that Carroll has joined Liverpool because he is certainly a player for the future. However, £35 million is way too much for a 22-year-old. And finally, a text from Stephen in Ireland, who is listening to us via the internet. I think it's ridiculous, all the money which was spent on the final day of the transfer window. Liverpool spending millions of pounds on Andy Carroll, who hasn't even played a full season in the Premier League. Now, as promised, it's over to Jeff and Matt with their wise words.
We're definitely no strangers to this time of evening, as we now discuss the week's hot topics in Jeff and Matt's Wise Words. Tonight's show is obviously regarding Transfer Deadline Day, or TDD as it is more commonly known in the footballing world.
Joining Matt and I this evening, as usual, is Adam and Trolls. Obviously, guys, the most notable transfer of the deadline day was Fernando Torres' £50 million move from Liverpool to Chelsea. And, of course, Andy Carroll moved for £35 million from Newcastle to Liverpool. So, Trolls, what are your views on the moves?
Well, 1.5 years ago, Ronaldo went to Real Madrid for £80 million. And Torres has proved for many years that he's one of the world's best strikers. So, paying £50 million quid for him is not overpricing, I think.
I heard a really good quote yesterday, actually, from BBC's pundit Mark Lawrenson. He said that, Fernando Torres went for £50 million and Andy Carroll went for £35 million. But at the end of the day, Liverpool have come out with it with £15 million profit. If Torres had gone for £25 million and Carroll had gone for £10 million, you'd have said fair enough.
I think Torres going to Chelsea is good for both teams because obviously he's proved himself at Liverpool over the last couple of years. Scoring 65 goals is no mean feat in just three seasons. He's still only 26, so he's got probably a good 10 more years as a striker in the Premier League. You've seen Sheringham play until he was 40. If Chelsea get 10 years out of Torres, then that's a really good deal for him.
I think Torres is in his prime, though, because he's 26 now. Chelsea bought Shevchenko 2007, was it, for £30 million?
That
and
was
he
a
was,
waste.
It was, and he was like 30 years old at the time. So at the end of the day, he's still in his prime. I reckon he's still got a good 4 or 5 years of playing decent football, and if we can get that out of him, then so be it.
Is Andy Carroll really worth £35 million to replace him, though? I mean, yeah, he had a good championship season last year, and he's had a good start to the Premiership this year, but £35 million for a 22-year-old?
For once, Matt, I actually agree with you, and it will be the once. £35 million is outrageous for a striker of 22. Like, £10-12 million would be ideal for Liverpool, but he's still got a lot to prove, having not played a full season in the Premier League. Championship-based, he was outstanding last year. But
look at the signing from Liverpool's perspective. They've got new owners, and they want to show that they can compete with the very best in the Premier League because they had a really disappointing season last season. And to compete, they needed better players, especially when Torres left. And English players are more expensive because of the homegrown rule. So if you want class, you have to pay like £35 million for a striker.
What about Rooney though, Charles? Because obviously you're the resident United supporter. Didn't he move from Everton to United when he was 18? How much was it?
Yeah, he was only 18. Yeah, and United paid £25 million for him.
And that seems to have worked out okay, isn't it?
He only had 2 seasons in Premier League.
Andy Carroll has no seasons in the Premier League though, and he's not had any experience at the World Cup against the world's best. He's just been playing against Championship.
But Rooney
players.
Hadn't either when he signed for us.
He played against Everton.
Against?
I mean, in Arsenal.
Is a goal against Arsenal enough to
especially
prove it
when he was only 16 or 17 at the time?
Basically, is Andy Carroll going to be the man to save Liverpool from the crisis that they're in at the moment?
No.
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 Absolutely not.
Well,
can I just pose this question to you? If the Torres deal went through, say, mid-January instead of on deadline day, and Andy Carroll went to Liverpool, would Liverpool have paid £35 million for him?
No, they were desperate.
They'd have got a better player for their money.
Right, lads, on our Twitter feeds, we got a few jokes coming in. One's from an angry Newcastle supporter called Mike NUFC, saying, "From now on, Andy Carroll will be playing with just Roll on his back. The Scousers have already stolen his car." Quite funny, isn't it? And another one from Gaz Mank. Wonder who that can be? "So, if Liverpool buy Luis Suarez and Andy Carroll, this means they'll have Lou and Andy up front."
Oh, well.
They're funny, aren't they?
Whether you agree or disagree with that, you can have your say by texting in on 81188 or via our Facebook page, We're In The Ball Official, or you can tweet to We're On The Ball Live.
Moving more local now, as our very own Matt and Jeff ask Huddersfield Town fans their thoughts on tonight's League One encounter against Carlisle United. But first, they spoke to Terriers striker Jordan Rhodes about Town's immediate future and whether he believes they are promotion candidates.
We sat nicely at the moment, sat in third position, so I think if we win the majority of his home games and pick up the odd point away from home, we stand a good chance of getting automatic.
What about the 4-0 deficit that you got to understand against Carlisle? Do you give yourself a chance for that?
Who knows? We just go out and do his best, like in every game. You try and win every game, so hopefully you know, just try and win the game first and foremost.
Obviously you're injured at the minute. How long are you out for, and do you look to be back soon?
Yeah, hopefully out for another couple of weeks. So, you know, progressing okay at the moment. So, you know, hopefully not too long.
What about promotion as well? Do you think that you finally got the squad to get out of League One this season?
Yeah, I thought so. We had a good squad last year, and the manager added to some good players this year to strengthen that. So, you know, the league's so tight at the moment. I think, you know, any amount of, you know, 7 or 8 teams can go up automatically. So, you know, it's just up to us to try and force that, really.
Do you think many changes will need to be made to cope in the Championship if you do go up?
Oh, I don't know. You look at the likes of Leeds and Norwich and Millwall that have not invested, you know, too heavily over the summer. And they're up in the playoffs in the Championship. So you never know. You never know.
News filtered through late last night that Town re-signed Danny Cadamarchi until the end of the season. Here is what some of the fans had to say about his return.
Very good. I like it.
He's only in as backup, so I guess it's an okay signing, but if he was first choice, I'm a bit concerned.
I wasn't a huge fan of Cadamarchi when he was here before, but we'll have to wait and see. I mean, he's a lot to prove. I'm not totally convinced, but you like him, don't you?
I liked him.
Yeah, I wasn't convinced about Cadamarchi, yeah. And I thought he left under suspicious circumstances, so I'm not overly thrilled to see him back.
They also asked the supporters their views on Town's chances on the League One fixture against Carlisle United.
Very good, actually. I think they've got a good chance of winning tonight, definitely, yeah.
I rate them pretty good after the performance at the Emirates, yes.
Well, we've got a lot to make up after last time we played Carlisle. They beat us 4-0, so I think on the back of a good game down at the Arsenal, we're expecting a good performance tonight.
Huddersfield also play Carlisle United in the Northern Final, second leg of the Johnson's Paint Trophy. Here is what the Terriers fans had to say on their chances of reaching Wembley.
Lennox are an absolute mountain to climb, but you can never give up, can you? You've got to have a go, and tonight, of course, is a good test for that.
It's going to be difficult.
It's going to be very difficult, but knowing Huddersfield Town, we always do things the hard way, so you never know.
So, guys, what are your predictions for the Huddersfield match tonight? Matt?
Well, the fans all seemed optimistic when we were at the ground. They're playing well in the league at the minute. They're fighting for an automatic promotion place behind Bournemouth and Brighton. I'm thinking they'll win a couple of goals to nil tonight.
Yeah, well, obviously they had a disappointing result against Carlisle in the JPT a couple of weeks ago, but they played really well against Arsenal on Sunday. So I'm going to predict a win, 2-1 Huddersfield.
Jules, one last word from you, mate, on a prediction?
1-0, Anthony Pilkington, definitely.
That's all we have time for on tonight's show. Join us again at the same time tomorrow, where I will be joined by Jeff and Matt. See you tomorrow, guys.
Cheers, Adam.
See ya.
Jules, will you be joining us again tomorrow?
For sure, I will.
We will also have reaction to how Huddersfield fare in tonight's match at the Gal Farm. After the news, we will have live commentary from the Gal Farm Stadium of Huddersfield Town's clash with Carlisle United, brought to you by the legendary Chris Kamara and injured Town goalkeeper Alex Smithers. Who's on the ball?
We're on the ball!